to cleanse the sun well.
Ugh. I really don't want to discard a Doomguard to another Doomguard, but it looks like it's going to happen at this rate. There's a chance I keep it. It's a small chance. It's 1 in 3, so like 5% probably, but that's okay. I like seeing this. He's not hero powering. Although, what would he hero power even? He's not swiping. That's the important thing. Alright, so he's gonna kill that. And... I just wanna slam Doomguard. Okay, I'm gonna do it. Come on, keep the other one. Nice. Definitely gonna trade, so it's much harder for him to kill Doomguard. I gotta hope this isn't one of the random Ancient of War lists. I don't think it is, because he's playing Argent Commander. Reynad thought I wanted his D just because we played a few league games. He doesn't talk to girls that much. Legendary Leah 2014. Really? Is that what she said? Into me, and then me asking whether she was into me, and her saying fuck yes, made me think she was into me. And then making out with me a few times, kind of. Yeah, I don't know. There were other signals besides playing League, but you know. What do I know? I guess I don't understand women at all. Oh shit, she didn't say that? Okay, I should have fact-checked before I... Let me preemptively address this. Too late, wrecked.
Well met.
It's actually the last one in my deck. This will protect Flamen. She says she has stories in me. She definitely has stories in me, that's true. I don't mind if those get out. The only reason I wasn't telling them is because it would make her look bad and another streamer. But yeah, those are pretty funny, actually. Shit. Did I trade? I think so. She's pissed. So many shots fired. I'm gonna try to stay away from Twitch drama. I don't give a shit. Doesn't affect me. Or, what's the word? Concern me. Change my play. Maybe. I think it's better to attack with the young priestess instead of the defender there to kill the 2-2. Because swipe is one of the only ways he can catch up, so I might as well make that less good against me by trading off the 2-1. If he doesn't have swipe, he can't catch up anyway. I wasn't even... I guess I'm glad I killed it. Shit, I wasn't even doing math on that. I guess I was really close to dead. You guys gotta try to start shit. I never sent her dick pics, I'll know. I would never do that. I saw it happen to Favre. How do you get all of it in frame, anyway? Tides of Time is in viewers, he's alive. Yeah, he's the one who told me about the YouPorn sponsorship. Rank 16 warrior. Crazy. Fibonacci. Alright, bud. Let's do it. Drawing a 2-drop is nice. Even if I didn't, life-tapping is really good in this matchup. I guess if I have Doomguard, it's not great, too. Just gotta hope he's not one of those sociopaths that plays Cleave.
I've got the beast in my sights. words just went over my head. La 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 la. For me, it's water under the bridge.
And we gotta just trade. Yeah, it's gonna set up a good defender. I'm still trading a 2-drop for a 3-drop. It's still a fine trade. Gonna lose the bubble for that, but that's worth. I wanna play defender on curve this turn, so if I'm doing that, I don't just wanna let him acolyte into my 1-5, so I have to kill the acolyte. The other option was to trade bubble for acolyte and then play flame imp and young priestess and life tap. Then I'm really vulnerable to whirlwind. That's a good draw. Probably no reason to play any more stuff. If he has Brawl though, I think there's a good chance he just plays it this turn. It's tough to ask for a better board than that. So Shield Slam on the 4-4. No, Armorsmith, interesting. I mean, I don't have to play more stuff, but I'm not really gonna have a turn where I can play this, considering the Doom Guard. So I'm just gonna drop that. I'm gonna hold this though for Brawl. This also increases the chances that something obnoxious wins the Brawl. He has a hard time dealing with Scarlet Crusader. I'm definitely gonna life tap every turn while I'm this far ahead. That's a fitting song. I'm gonna life tap first to have the highest odds of Doomguard keeping the other Doomguard alive. Well, yeah. Fuck. I'm gonna trade the 3-1. 2-2 is better because it survives Whirlwind, Taskmaster. Some of them play Inner Rage randomly. Dude, I am awkward. Mean Girls 3. Mean Girls 3. So good. Cleanse the Sunwell. Alright, no Brawl Reno, please. I drew the Doom Guards together so Brawl would fuck me. Is Shield Block Brawl? No, thank you. Okay. Well, telling met. Everyone the story. What fucking story? Thanks for subbing, Murphus. What is this bitch saying? Hold up. And you guys all exacerbate this shit. Like, you give her attention. It's the worst thing.
You fucktard. So because you were denied, it's not my fault, you fuck. I didn't write that back to him, but if he wants to start talking shit, I just mean he's a socially awkward person, and I don't want this to happen, but I'm annoyed that he's saying shit about me that's not true, and this shit is true, and you can ask Celeste about it when she streams.
Oh, shit. Get in there and fight, maggot. She mad. Well, Oh, man. Let me think about this. Oh, man. You guys want Leah's story. The thing is, there's one other streamer involved. I don't want to make her mad at me. But she's like an important, well, sort of an important part of the story. I guess I can... No, okay. I guess I can just tell a story without that part. Ugh. This is quality streaming? Yeah. That Twitch drama, though. Yo, I'm super awkward around girls, though. She's absolutely right. I'm just a socially awkward person. That's true for, like, a lot of people in esports and gaming, though, you know? This is the best. This is super worth it for the sub. Yeah, okay. All right, guys. I'm gonna mute music. If you want the Leah story, that's fine. You know, I'm not gonna blast this all over YouTube because I don't want an attention whore to get more viewers based off of shit like this happening. Like she, you know, piggybacked off of Soda to get to where she is now. But anyway, but you know, I will bring it up this one time on stream, and people, you guys can highlight it later or whatever the fuck you want for everyone that asks in the future. Right, so, Leah story. There isn't like a real Leah story type of thing. It's just like, I actually kind of told the story of how I got to streaming to where I am today, right? Earlier in the stream. Long story short, I got popular in winter, like January or something. And, hold up. Oh, couldn't quite get it. Alright, so I get popular in January or something. And I try to be interactive with chat and shit. You know, everyone tries at a certain, you know, up to a certain point. And one day chat randomly, I forgot why it started, but people were just like, you know, what you usually do, where you keep bringing up Leah shit and you're like trying to get me to hit on her or something. To which my response is, who the fuck is Leah, right? Because I don't know who that is. Apparently she subbed me a couple days ago, but I read it as Legendary Lee. So anyway, I looked at her channel, and I'm like, oh, okay, cute blonde girl, sure, why not? You know, I'll hit on her and all that. So, well, not like actively or anything, nothing really came of it. I got her Skype, and we're like flirting back and forth a little bit and all that shit. Anyway, I find out she's living in Virginia with some boyfriend that she's been dating for like 8 years or some shit. Heston, that's the guy's name. Right, so like, you know, some doctor will have boyfriend guy, so I'm like, yeah, okay, whatever, I'll drop it. But then, so I don't talk to her at all, right? Like, I just keep doing my streaming thing, and eventually she messages me back, like, oh, let's play some more games where we, like, play against autofill decks and all that. You know, like, trying to snowball the whole... Using, like, my audience to build her audience. Same thing she did with Soda, right? And, to which I just ignore her, right? Like, I don't say anything about that. Right, then eventually we start talking more, and she's like, no, I'm not dating Heston anymore and all that shit, and... After a couple weeks, she moves to California. So I'm like, oh, maybe that's true. You know, maybe she's not dating this guy. We start flirting more, all that shit. You know, and we play League and stuff. Like, I'd get done streaming. We'd get in a Skype call with, like, her and some random World of Warcraft players who are actually pretty cool guys. Like, now I've gotten to meet them. But, yeah, so anyway. Where's it going with this? Right, so we're, like, flirting and stuff, and... You know, she spends an inordinate amount of time bitching about Soda, to which is like, you know, big red flags. I'm like, yeah, okay, whatever. I know there's some drama with you and this, like, other guy's streams. Whatever, so I'm just up front with her about it. I'm like, hey, if you want to date Soda, like, just fucking tell me. Like, don't string me along this whole time. All that kind of stuff. And, she's like, no, I'm super into you. I'm not dating Heston. Fuck Soda, I would never date him again. That was the fucking worst, blah, blah, blah. I'm like, yeah, okay, sure. So we start flirting some more and stuff. She sends me like a topless Snapchat and stuff. And I'm like, yeah, okay, sure. We'll see you at DreamHack and all that. So we get to DreamHack the first night there. Everyone's drinking up in her hotel room. And that's what the video on Gara's channel is about. So, yeah. So we, wait, hold up. God, I don't want to get greedy so bad. Please, based Soulfire one fucking time. hate this video game. Anyway, where was I? So, we go to, yeah, we go to DreamHack. Everyone's drinking in a hotel room, like, the first night. So, I'm meeting people all there. There's a couple girls up there. There's, like, another streamer girl. It's really cute. And, yeah, so, I'm being my socially awkward self, right? I got shit face, and I smile, nod, you know, all that, you know. Talk to people as much as I can and all that. And, things are going well, and, yeah, long story short, I mean, a lot of stuff happened that night. We got a Dignitas player arrested accidentally. I remember, that was a crazy fucking... But anyway, yeah, we, like... What even happened? Yeah, we make out a couple times throughout the course of the night and all that shit, and there was... Went to, like, a club and stuff, and then we go back to the hotel after all that stuff happened. Yeah. I'm kind of flirting with this other streamer girl the whole time, because, I mean, yeah, Leah's hot, but it's not, like, she's not someone I'm invested in or anything, you know, I'm not really expecting much, and, yeah, so long story short, it gets to the end of the night, and, you know, Leah and I are talking all that with this other streamer girl there, and we're like, what do we even say? One is, I asked her to come back to my place, because I rented, like a house and stuff, and she was giving me, like, every signal that, it was going well, and, she's being all hesitant. She's like, oh, I don't know, da-da-da-da-da. And we don't want to be loud, and, like, there's a bunch of people sleeping in her, hotel room, like, a bunch of friends, like, six people in there, right? So we didn't want to wake them up, and we didn't want to, like, talk about this shit in the hallway. So we went to, like, the stairwell at the end of the hallway, which we thought was, like, soundproof, but it was actually a giant concrete microphone, basically, or loudspeaker. Anyway, point is, everyone in the hotel could hear us, and we didn't fucking know this. So, I'm drunk, I'm a 22-year-old guy, I'm trying to set up a situation where I can disappoint two women at once. That definitely did not work out. And, so, what happened? Yeah, so I asked Leah if she wants to go back to my place. She's all hesitant. And then Soda, like, runs down the hallway. He's like, So I was like, oh, you know, I have an extra bed at my place. Just come crash in my room. And she just, like, bolts off right away. You know, like, doesn't argue at all. I'm like, oh, okay, you know, that's a pretty clear signal. So I spend the night with this other girl. And, this other streamer girl. So then Leah and I don't really talk for, like, the next couple days, because the whole time I'm playing the Hearthstone tournament, I'm casting, I'm doing sponsor shit, like, I'm busy, I'm there to work. But after the DreamHack trip, we're all going to Amsterdam afterwards to, like, you know, see the city and hang out and stuff. And, what happens there? Right, so basically Leah and I don't talk for a while. Oh yeah, the camera story kind of plays into this. It's a really fucking complicated weekend to try to say in story form. Okay, so, like, one of the last days of DreamHack, last day of competition, I spilled tea all over myself in the morning, and, so, Forsen gave me an extra shirt, so I grabbed it, and I went to go change in the bathroom, and, I had Tide's video camera on me, because we brought it with to kind of record vlog stuff, even though we never actually uploaded it, because we're lazy as shit. Should have had Trump as... No, I mean, DreamHack worked out fine in terms of women. Like, it was a good time. Anyway, where was I with this? Right, so I go into the bathroom to change, and I left the camera there, right? So, I forgot the camera in the bathroom, and I don't notice for a couple hours. So, eventually, I'm like, oh shit, I lost Tide's camera. I gotta go find it. So, I go to the info booth, because I was gonna ask where the Lost and Found was. Apparently, it was at the info booth. But yeah, there was a cute Swedish girl working there, and, you know, we hit it off, started talking. I worked my ass off to get her, like, an extra bracelet thing for the Twitch party afterwards, because at all... But, where's I going with this? Yeah, so basically, Leah and I talked beforehand at DreamHack. She's like, oh, I'm gonna see you at the Twitch party, right? And I'm like, yeah, I'll see me at the Twitch party and all that. So anyway, I show up to the Twitch party. I brought this nice Swedish girl with me. You know, we're hitting it off. We're having a good time. I'm meeting other streamers like Kung and Phantomlore, like guys I really respect. You know, it's going fun, or it's going well, and I'm having a fun time, and drinking and stuff. So, we see Leah there, and then like her and a whole bunch of other people are fucking tripping balls on Molly or some shit, like ecstasy. I don't even remember what it was. I can roll my eyes, you know, do the hug thing. Hi, Leah, you know, all that. Anyway, go home with a nice Swedish girl. Like, best part of the trip by far. And then, where is I going with this? So, yeah, in a couple days, we're flying out to Amsterdam. Last day of DreamHack, we have, like, a day to relax. We're hungover. I sleep for the first time all weekend for more than an hour. Like, you know, one day was to chill. The day after that, we're flying out for Amsterdam. So Tides and Gara on the way home. I'm on a flight to Amsterdam with, you know, Leah and Kitty and Carvenin, who's was a really high-ranked paladin player in World of Warcraft. Some of you guys who played WoW might know him. And then Merc, who is also, I think, really high up in... I think he was also... Yeah, he was a high warrior player, I want to say, or something. I don't know shit about World of Warcraft. Anyway... Yeah, so we go to Amsterdam. I just want to have a good time. I want to meet, you know, I want to socialize, maybe meet a nice girl from the Netherlands. I just want to drink and stuff, see the city. And, anyway, where is I going with this? Right, so this is the part that annoyed me about Amsterdam. We go to, we're like all in the same apartment, right? We're renting an apartment, and it's like the five of us staying there. So, yeah, we go see the city, we get some drinks, you know, there's like coffee shops where they sell really weak pot and stuff like that. Just the usual, you know, Amsterdam stuff. Should I coin this? I don't think I should coin this. She's trying to damage control so hard right now. Yeah. No, let me sub mode off this. Don't turn sub mode on again. Alright, where was I going with this? Where were we? We were at Amsterdam, right? I'm actually going to play this instead of Harvest in case he has Shattered Sun. And I think I'm going to Soulfire now. I really want to make sure I play this, though.
Well met!
Alright, where was I? Alright, so we're in Amsterdam, we're seeing the city, all that stuff. And, basically this entire time, Leah's having, like, the first day is pretty fun, all of that. Second day... It's just so hard to remember the fucking timeline. Like, I know the important things that happen, but I'm trying to, like, order them. There's very little of this weekend that I was sober during, so... Where is I going with this? Alright, anyway, long story short, one of these nights, they end up taking, like, fucking, not me, but, well, no, I took, like, a handful, but, because peer pressure, but I didn't fucking enjoy it. But they took this, like, truffles, it's kind of like mushrooms, but different, or weaker, or something, I don't fucking know. Point is, they had no effect on me, but everyone else is tripping balls and laughing their ass off. And then, somewhere throughout this, Leah, fucking, you know, 3 feet in front of me, when she was pretending to be really into me for like the past several weeks, has this existential crisis where she has a breakdown about like, what the fuck did I do? Oh my god, I'm so stupid. Why did I break up with Heston? Oh my god. And I'm just like rolling my eyes. I mean, I'm just insulted more than anything at this shit's going on like right in front of me. So I just fucking leave, go get some drinks, talk to some locals at a bar, you know. I want to have a good time while I'm in Europe, all that stuff.